As a high school student taking AP and honors courses, I believe mental health education is extremely important, not only to the youth, but to parents, guardians, friends, aunts, uncles.
Some might say these San Diego Unified students represent the voices of the future, but these young students are making sure they're heard now. They are speaking out on mental health. As so many families know, this pandemic has been hard on students who went from the classroom to, in many cases, isolated virtual learning. According to the CDC, there was a 31% increase in mental health-related emergency visits among teenagers between March 2020, when the lockdown started, and October 2020. And suicide does remain the second leading cause of death among students between the ages of 15 and 19 in the U.S. ABC 10 News anchor Mary McKenzie joins us live from home. Mary, the students who were speaking there wanted to make sure they and their families, classmates, have resources from the district.
And that's what this is really about. There were dozens of students who came to the board meeting last night. This campaign, this resolution, will make mental health a required course for all middle and high school students within the district, and will provide resources that will trickle down to elementary schools as well.
Students will learn about identifying warning signs, and they will learn about mental illness, but they will also learn the importance of finding a solution, of spreading resources, and of making an impact.
And the idea for mental health education in the core curriculum was developed by students like Kate Chasen, who is a junior in high school. She started the SWEAR committee, which is Student Wellness, Education, and Resources. They met with the board president and trustees months ago, lobbying for this resolution to establish mental health education within the core curriculum. And that's what this became, the mental health education resolution. It passed, as you said, unanimously last night, the district citing those staggering statistics, such as the one you mentioned, suicide being the second leading cause of death for students aged 15 to 19 in the United States. So now, with the mental health and well-being of students being overburdened by the pandemic, challenges related specifically to remote learning, these initiatives are designed to be student-centered and student-created to help reduce things like the mental health stigma and have these difficult conversations. Another push by the SWEAR committee that they worked on was to make mental health an excused absence, which as of this year, it now is in the district. And they'll also be offering a micro credential for teachers in mental health and wellness going forward. So details to come on the program, but they expect to implement it in fall of this year. Reporting live from home, Mary McKenzie, ABC 10 News.
Thank you, Mary. And a quick reminder, there is help for anyone struggling with their mental health, no matter what the situation. And you see the number to call on your screen. It's 888-724-7240.